name is Amy Teresian Parisi. I am the Director of Alumni Relations, and I would like to thank you all for joining us this evening. I am now honored to welcome, for the last time as she is completing her term, the President of our Alumni Association, Board of Directors, and past Cornelius Award recipient, and a new grandmother, as her son and daughter-in-law just welcomed a healthy new baby boy today, Monica Judge.
Thank you. Yes, we are just so excited. This is our first grandchild, so you can imagine what it's like. On behalf of the Alumni Board, I would like to welcome you here this evening. I would especially like to congratulate and welcome the Jubilarians from the class of 1963 who are celebrating their 50th anniversary. I hope you're all enjoying yourselves and taking this opportunity to reconnect with old friends. It's hard for me to believe that this is the fifth year that I have been up here welcoming everyone to the Reunion Gala. Since I have served one term as Vice President and two terms as President of the Alumni Board, it is now time for me to step aside and let someone else take the reins. I will still be involved because Iona has become a part of my family over the years. And as you know, it's very hard to turn your back on family. At this time, I'd like to introduce to you some of that family. As I mention your name, I would ask that these board members stand to be recognized. Al DiCristino, Carol Pagano Farish, Ed Foldesi, one of our Jubilarians, Dahlia Madison, Claire Munjiguera, John Tangredi, and Helen O'Dell. I want to congratulate all the award recipients and tell them how proud we are to call them alumni. I would like to thank the Internal Affairs Committee of the Alumni Board for their diligent hard work in choosing the candidates that we are honoring here this evening. Most of all, I also need to thank Amy Parisi and her competent alumni relations staff who have put in endless hours. Yes, please give them a round of applause. They have put in endless hours to make this evening the success that it always is, and for making my time on the board so enjoyable. Finally, I would like to thank my own family for putting up with me, or maybe I should say the absence of me, and for all of you for attending this evening and for your support of Iona College. Please continue to keep us all in your hearts and in your prayers. And now I would like to invite Brother Bob Novak up to do the invocation.
Thank you, Monica. Let us pray. Dear Lord, on the day that we celebrate the graduation of Iona's class of 2013, we ask you to bless our alumni and their families, especially the 50-year group and the classes of the threes and the eights who are gathered here this evening. Iona takes its name from the Isle of Iona, where in 563 AD, St. Columba founded a monastery that is still a center of learning and missionary activity. Our Iona College was founded by the Christian Brothers, whose founder, Blessed Evan Rice, was a businessman who used his talents to establish schools to educate the youth in Ireland and England. We are part of that vision begun by St. Columba and Blessed Evan Rice. We continue that vision by spreading the knowledge, grace, and blessings that we receive at today's Iona to whomever we meet in our lives. As we journey on life's way, may we remain, like Columba and Edmund, strong in faith, firm in hope, and active in charity. Help us to fight the good fight in faith. Finally, bless this food that we are about to receive and the conversation and good spirit that we share around the tables this evening. This we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
All I've ever wanted to be is a television reporter. Growing up, I watched Barbara Walters and Katie Couric, and I aspired to do what they do. Now, when the time came to choose a college, I knew I needed to be in New York and to find a place where I could transform a pipe dream into an actual reality. Iona has far exceeded my expectations of what I hoped for in a college. Remember, let me take you back to my freshman year. I had just attended my very first ICTV meeting, that's the student-run television station, and I walked out of Murphy Center with my head spinning. Who were these other students who had accomplished so much and knew so much more than me about this industry? I distinctly remember calling my dad and telling him in a panic, "I need to switch majors, I don't know anything about being a reporter, and I just can't do it." As he always does in his dad way, he calmed me down and assured me that this is what college is for, that no freshman has it figured out. Relive. Now fast forward 3 years and let me recount for you some of what I've accomplished during my college career. I stood before Eli Manning with a microphone and asked him questions about the game. I've brushed elbows with Brian Ross and Diane Sawyer as an intern at ABC. I've even collaborated on a news story that was featured on abcnews.com and got to see my name published underneath the headline. I've been co-host of a radio show, seen and heard by local Westchester guests and Iona students and faculty. I've stood on the sidelines in Mulcahy and reported for the men and women's basketball teams. President Nyer even let me put a camera in his face and ask him a few questions from time to time. Reignite. Now, there's a spark that lights within me when I think about Iona College. It's an excitable feeling that I'm confident many of you can identify with. I believe that Iona's greatest asset is its people. My professors constantly push me to do great things and afford me every opportunity in doing journalism. The administrators I've worked closely with have done their best to keep students at the forefront of their minds when making decisions. And finally, the incredible alumni community, you all here tonight, deserve so much of the credit. Your support has meant a scholarship that I would not be here without. You've been mentors to students like me, and I can tell you firsthand that your advice is invaluable to an undergrad. This is the kind of kindred spirit that sets Iona apart from other schools. It's what allows Iona to grow and continue to succeed. And while I certainly don't wish away my last year as a college student, I'm excited for the day when I'll become a member of the alumni community of Iona College. And you can believe I'll return the favor and offer support to some freshman girl who is freaked out and calling her dad. So thank you for being here tonight. Thank you for listening to my story and for being the strong foundation that our school continues to build upon. Thank you.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on a Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. fill my heart with song and let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words.